السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Blessings to all of you. In Sufism there is a saying that says every brother is a mirror to you. No? And usually we don't really think about it, or we don't really understand the complexity and the consequences of that saying. It is not that what you see in the brother, it is not only what you like in the other, yeah, but it is basically what you don't like. Yeah. And that is actually the help that others can give to us. Because we mentioned in the last talks that there is consciousness and there's a subconsciousness. And the subconsciousness is the much bigger place in ourselves, and that represents the other. Yeah. That is the other. So this is your partner. This can be your parents, that is your family, that is everybody outside there. Yeah. And so when we see something which we don't like, then we have to look at that in ourselves. That is the basic training, that is the basic awakening, let's say, about your own self. Because it is difficult to see in your blind spots, but it's not difficult for the other. Yeah. So the other reacts on us clearer because it's not involved in our story. It's not blinded by our blind spots, it's blinded by its blind spots. So we reflect each other's blind spots. And sometimes, for example, you may have days that you think everyone is angry outside there, no? But you think yourself that you're not angry, right? And you see everyone angry. You see everyone maybe also aggressive. And don't waste your time in looking to the others and say, oh, what are angry people all there. But stop and look what anger you are holding in yourself, what you are oppressing. Because once you oppress too much, it comes stronger and stronger in your field, it comes out in the other. No? And that is the way we awaken. We need usually somebody to see ourselves, to be reflected. No? And in the matrix, that is what we can call also a mirror. The matrix is a mirror, and we were speaking about that before. There is not only one mirror, there are several mirrors, right? But the first one is about people, how we reflect ourselves in people. So there is a good test that you can do. For example, if you say to others, how do you see me? No? And first you ask yourself how you want to be seen. Let's say you think that you are a very calm person, but others see you not like that. Then look that aspect that is not calm in you. Yeah? Or the way around, you think that you're very angry, but others see you very calm. Yeah? There can be also this kind of projections. Therefore, it says in our tariqat that the goodness comes out of the community. Because there you have mirrors, lots of mirrors. You can deny one mirror, you can deny two mirrors. But if 20 mirrors say to you the same thing, that means God speaks. Yeah. And you cannot deny it. You cannot fight it down in you anymore. Right? And that is the goodness of the community. It doesn't mean that everything is roses and honey in a spiritual community. Is the opposite, actually, because more people have this intention to get reflected, the more we ask also to come, to things come up. You know? So you find very often in spiritual communities a lot of not peaceful situations, yeah, a lot of conflicts. Yeah. And the reason is simply because they want to know. That is at least their conscious intention. Then you will come to a point inside of yourself that the closer you come to the real ego structure, the more resistance you will develop. Yeah. And you will understand that you want and you don't want. And this is the situation on our planet. We want consciously peace, but our subconscious doesn't support that, doesn't want that. And as we are all connected, you have to understand that there is not anybody single or disconnected. So everything we are reflects finally in the collective as well. So if we would be all collectively be happy and peaceful, we will live in a peaceful society. Yeah. But we are collectively in the majority aggressive, angry, jealous, envy, proud, and so on and so on. So the work is always starting in yourself. And this is what we said when we talked about the heart revolution. You make this work. You awaken as much as you can for your blind spots. And that, again, inspires also all the others around you, because everyone has the same direction. He wants to know. Yeah. And once you see, first you want to know yourself. Then you want to know where is your origin. Yeah. And then you will understand where you are from and what it is about here. That is the step we are now into it. And that is the work. Yeah. In Sufism, we love to work. It is one of the pillars of our path. To do inner work and, of course, also outer work. There is no holidays. There is no day where you don't work. Yeah. That does not mean that you cannot relax and that you cannot have an easy day. But the inner work actually never stops. Yeah. It's always on. Like the sun is always shining. It doesn't stop 1 second, it doesn't stop ever. If it would do so, we would be in shock. If one day the sun would appear only for 1 hour, yeah, we would be in a complete shock. Yeah. 1 minute already, it would shock us. Yeah. So it's there, and it's very, very important that it is there. That's why a great Sufi master said, as long as the sun is rising up in the morning, you don't have to worry. This is our one pillar. If that is not happening anymore, then you know something will come really to an end. Yeah. So don't think too much about what will be an end or what will come or how this world will develop. At the end of the day, this is not our business. We cannot know. Yeah. But you can know your business, and this is the work you have to do. And the one who works hard, yeah, comes to his heart, right? That's how it is. You become a hard worker, and finally you become a heart worker, right? And that is the step. Thank you very much. All the best to you. Hear you soon. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.